All right, I'm back with another playthrough of Project Zomboid. I'm working on trying to get Bobby Clark, who is in the same world as the last guy, so it's all like 3 months into the game already with no food and no water and no electricity. I'm gonna see if I can get him back to the base. From Sam Nelson's. Not a lot. Decent amount, actually. Alright, so the easiest way to do this would be to find a vehicle with some gas in it and drive as quickly as I can, but that's not going to be easy. Okay, so I've been told that I haven't been talking as much as I should in these videos, so I'm going to try and keep up a little bit more talkative pace of stuff. We'll see if I can do that. All right, any of these bad boys have gas? No gas there. Time to skedaddle from this area. So at this point, I'm considering if I have enough supplies to just make the walk to the next town over. I'm being chased by a whole bunch of zombies. I know that if I walk out into the wilderness, I can potentially find a place where there's no zombies. But I don't know if I have enough water. I was just checking my inventory to see if I had stuff for lighting a fire, which I do. So I could potentially use that. I think I'm going to just walk north to the river and see if I can get there. I don't like that moderate exertion. All right, well, looks like this is the thing. If he doesn't survive, then he doesn't survive. How's my water supply? Not bad. I'd prefer it to be a little bit better. This way. Going on a sojourn. If that takes up to high exertion, I could be in some serious trouble. Hopefully, I'll find a place to rest at some point and some place with some extra water as well. Does that guy have a machete? Is that two machete? I would like another machete. It's hard to tell. It could be anything, though. And I can't fight that many zombies. Oh well. So this is the disadvantage of clumsy, is that zombies, when you're even just regular walking, hear you from a much longer distance. So to I'm using regular walking because it's slightly faster than the pace that zombies can go. So theoretically I should get out of here, but new zombies keep hearing me, which makes things complicated. I'm trying my best to avoid the big groups of them, but it's not very easy. Looks like I've only got one following me right now. He's a pretty slow shambler. I really need to reduce my exhaustion. And my tiredness is going to be a problem as well. Just gotta keep walking. Can't stop. It's going to be a long walk. Gotta stick to the road, otherwise I'll lose track of things. Because when it gets super dark, it's gonna be hard to see anything if I'm not on the road. It's gonna be hard to see things even when I am on the road. Gotta use shift sparingly. Every time I dash, it reduces my endurance a little bit. And if my endurance drops to the speed where I can't outrun any zombies, then I'm probably just dead. Doesn't sound like there's anybody following me, but I'm gonna keep walking. Oh, now there's somebody following me. My road. doesn't seem to be so many people out here, so that's good. And by people, I of course mean zombies. Alright. I don't know where I'm going. I'm tired. Still only got moderate exertion. Ooh, it's only gonna get darker. I didn't grab a flashlight. That was silly of me. That's my water. Not terrible. I have no idea where this road ends. hurt any zombies for a while. But I'm not confident in walking at a normal speed at this time because of, I'd prefer to sneak past any that are off the side of the road that I can't see. Don't know if it'll work. But doesn't hurt to try. Looks like it's not actually getting any darker either, so that's good. What's this? Oh, I think I've been here before in one of my other playthroughs. This is like the double warehouse. Was that lighter? Okay. Chair sleeping time. Let's see if I can fill up my water bottle here too. No water. Oh, that looks like a sink. All right. Let's take that cooking pot too and fill it up just in case. Okay. So that should be enough water to get me to my destination. There's a farm. Whoa. Yikes. Okay. Big pile of zombies over there. Let's eat a little bit of something. Don't want more thirst. Delicious dog food. There's a farmer house here. Let's see. If it has any food. Chips. Another water bottle. Well, that'll have to do. Looks like that. Oh, left to right. Wonder if that's got keys in it. Fire pants are so good. Military boots are so good. No key. All right, well, I got some nice equipment, didn't get anything else, but my protection's pretty high right now, which is definitely always useful. The upper torso's a little low. Ooh, what's this? A big road. All right, left or right? Looks like left. Come here. All right, got enough food and water, hopefully, to make it back to the other place that I... Oh. I'm not going to make the same mistake of trying to fight zombies that aren't falling down. Base a bit. Off we go. Is that just three? Maybe I'll just walk around though. No, I think I can take them. Especially now. I would really, really up digital watch to replace this alarm clock I'm carrying around. My dog food. Take a wide berth around those ones. Looks like it's just three, but... apparently one that way. Starting to get late again. Get out of here, formal shirt. Trying to just bail. Time to casually walk away from a bunch of zombies. And I'm not even tired. Well, exerted. And I'm losing. Well, I have my weight stable right now. Right turn. If I can't see them, it's like they're not there. What are my good traits? Nope. Nope. God damn, that's a nope. All of my first good traits are terrible. Well, that's what happens when you play a random character. I'm still kind of on the fence about whether it's better to just walk quickly at nighttime or to sneak. I think that if you're tired, if you're like physically exhausted, it's better to sneak so that you don't have to worry about getting overtired. But I think that if you're got, you don't have the exertion moodle, that you should just quick walk, because then you're less likely to get caught by a zombie you didn't see. Oh, out of dog food. right turn. This road is not filling me with lots of confidence. Sunlight. All right, what else have I got for food? Level back up to peckish. Yeah, that road just died. All right. This way we go. All right, so that river goes by the entire thing. So if I just keep walking in this direction, I should find it, and then I should be able to go either east or west to get back to the city that I know so well. That has almost 1,000 zombies removed from it. And back to the safe house. Well, this doesn't count as scavenge area, so I must be getting close to something. Unless I'm at like the north end of something and I'm about to go into scavenge territory. Hard to say. Oh, yep, there we go. That was the case. At least the trees are fairly sparse here. I was just thinking about how much this game has changed since I first started playing it, and it's pretty impressive. The original version of the game was a very small map, a few blocks, city blocks comparatively, with like less than 50 buildings in it, and you couldn't leave the map. It was just a line of trees that were immobile all the way around. Oh, what's this? Some dead guy out in the forest. Oh. Well, that explains why he's dead. I'm so tired, so I'm not gonna bother wasting my spear. Tiredness gives really low accuracy. But yeah, so, and there was always the exact same amount of food in the game. So there was, each looting container was predetermined how much it had in it. It was all set up. And there was no way to grow more food or anything. So once you were out of food, you were out of food, and that was it. You had to figure out how to efficiently use your food if you wanted to survive. I think I'll go right. I'm trying to decide if I should continue following this road or just go up through the woods more. I think I want to go up through the woods more. All the leaves are starting to fall off the trees. That's cool. I've never seen that before. Other than the evergreens, of course. Could I cut down a tree with? I don't have any tree cutting tools. Do I? Oh, I do have a raw axe. Okay, cool. Right, I made that last time. Time to eat some more carrots. There seems to be a path through this woods. Alright, I'll follow that. Is this a campground? Like a couple of sheds. Is this a stable? Looks like a stable. Totally a stable. Okay. Little stable, little shed. Neat. Not super useful, but neat. It's fun, this game is so huge, and they designed, there's not like anything random about it, so somebody built that area. And I'm curious as to where it goes. I've never seen, like, you can play this game so often and still never see everything in it, because it's just such a big game. We'll keep following this path because I'm curious to see where it goes. Hopefully it's not like a loop. That would be funny. If it starts going back this way, then I will stop following it. Ooh, what's that? A fence. Neat. Maybe I'm making my way back to civilization. This is like an ATV path or a horse trail, I guess. Cement blocks. That looks like a parking lot. Where am I? Nope, it's just a road. Well, this way we go. No zombies, that's good. Alright, but I think at this point I'm going to have to just end it for today. But I'll be back probably tomorrow. Alright, thanks for watching.